Hello, Garrett here with Boats.net. Today we're working on a 1999 Yamaha B90TLRX. What we're doing to it is actually replacing the water pump. It's not too tough of a job to do, just need to tilt the engine up, drop the lower unit, and pull out the impeller. So let me go grab a couple tools and we can get started. Okay, this job can be a little bit tricky, so I'm gonna rate it as a skill level 2, but it's really not that bad, so don't get too scared. Okay, as far as the tools go, you're gonna need a hammer, a punch, a 3/8 ratchet, a 3/8 extension, a pry bar of some sort, a 12 millimeter deep well socket, a 14 millimeter shallow socket, possibly a 14 millimeter wrench, and lastly, a torque wrench. Now, as far as the parts go, you can check us out at boats.net. There, we have exploded diagrams that give you a really close-up view of how everything comes apart, and more importantly, how it goes back together. So, get your parts and tools together, and let's turn some wrenches. Okay, first things first, let's go ahead and tilt the engine up. Simply just lifting up the engine. And then lowering this lever. Okay, now that we've got our engine tilted up, let's go ahead and start removing the lower unit. All right, the first thing we're gonna wanna do is actually remove our trim tab. But before we do that, it's a good idea to take you a marker and actually just mark you a mark on the trim tab. That way, when we put it all back together, we can set it to the appropriate spot. Do is we're going to remove this plastic cap, and underneath it is a 12 millimeter bolt that holds the trim tab in place. Just like that. And if you look underneath the trim tab, there's actually a 12 millimeter bolt that we have to remove as well. Okay, next up is we have to remove the four 14 millimeter bolts that hold the lower unit to the engine. When you do this, you wanna make sure that you remove three of them first, leave the fourth one still tight, and slowly back it off, because as you back it off, the lower unit's gonna try to drop, and you don't want it falling on your feet. Plus, there's a water pickup hose that we gotta disconnect as well. Okay, before we completely drop the lower unit down, let's go ahead and disconnect the water pickup tube. I'm gonna do that by just cutting off this zip tie that's holding it on. Just like that. Pay attention, you can notice that the lower unit is starting to separate as I back off this last bolt. Now we're gonna hold it, brace it with our leg, and then gently slide it out. Gently slide it out, just like this. All right, now that I've got the lower unit pulled off, let me put it on my stand over here, and then we can start on the water pump. Okay, we've got our lower unit on the stand here. Now we're gonna unbolt the four 12 millimeter bolts that's actually holding the upper water pump housing on. When you do this, you wanna make sure and take note that there's two different lengths of bolts. So make sure you remember where they go back in. Okay, we're gonna remove our four bolts. And then slide our upper cover all the way up. What we're gonna do now is we're gonna inspect on the inside for any type of damage. And judging by the looks of this one, all the ears are still intact. This upper housing looks like it's still in great shape. So we should be able to use this one. All right, next we're gonna remove the cup. And a quick and simple way to do that is to take your drive shaft, twist it in a clockwise motion as you lift up on the cup, and it'll come off that simple. Just like that. All right, the next thing we wanna do is actually remove the impeller itself. You can do that by taking your little flathead screwdriver and just gently around the bottom, just kind of pry it up little by little until it starts to work its way up. Just like that. Now that we've got the impeller off, if you take a look here, you can notice how there's a tear in this water pump impeller. That's more than likely the reason why it wasn't pumping water. So we're definitely gonna replace the impeller. Next thing we're gonna do is remove our woodruff key. And we do that by taking a punch and a hammer and tapping the top end of the woodruff key until it just rotates out of the sleeve. Just like that. All right, now that the woodruff key's out of the way, we can actually begin to remove the plate and then the gasket beneath it. That way we can check out the condition of the housing. Okay, if you look at the housing, you can obviously tell that we replaced this housing. But what you wanna look for is a lot of corrosion buildup in these channels in the housing itself. You also wanna inspect for any cracks. If there's any cracks or if the corrosion is just too bad, it's a good idea to go ahead and replace it. But since we've done that already with this one, I'm not gonna replace it. All right, the next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna install our new gasket that came in our water pump kit. And then with the plate, if you look at the plate here, you can tell that these fins are ridged. You wanna make sure that those are facing down when you put it on the engine. All right, those are facing down. Next up is the woodruff key. By just putting it inside the channel, like so, and just tap it in with a hammer. We wanna make sure that the woodruff key goes in line with the drive shaft, just like this. All right, next thing to do is actually install our impeller. And if you look closely at the bottom side of the impeller, there's actually a notch cut out for the woodruff key to sit down inside of, and directly next to it is a fin. So it's a good idea to put your fingers on that fin so you know where the notch is at when you're putting it on. So it makes it a lot easier to line them up that way. And before we actually slide it down on the shaft, I'm gonna take some Yamaha marine grease and we're gonna actually put it down the inside of the impeller. And it's a good idea to put some on the shaft itself. And just line up that fin with the woodruff key and then slide it on, just like that. We're gonna do the same thing with the cup as we did with our impeller. We're gonna coat the inside of the cup with grease, and this cup's gonna go on the same way as it came off. What we're gonna do is we're gonna set it on top of the impeller, take our drive shaft, spin it in a clockwise motion, and the impeller will go on just like that. Now, the last thing is the upper water pump housing. And it slides on just like that. Now we're gonna take our new bolts that came in our kit and put the long ones up front. And then our shorter ones in the back. Okay, when you go to tighten these back down, you don't wanna over tighten them because remember this housing's plastic. So just take caution when you go to tighten them back up because you definitely don't wanna crack it. You just want them good and snug. Don't over tighten them. Okay, now that we've got the water pump all assembled, now we need to prep the lower unit for installing it back on the engine. And we do that by taking our marine grease and putting the coat on the splines at the end of the drive shaft, as well as the shift shaft. That's gonna help us slide everything back together. Okay, now that we've got the lower unit prepped to go back on the motor, I'm gonna take one of the lower unit bolts that I took off, carry it with me, already have it in hand. That way, whenever I line everything up, I can go ahead and thread one bolt in. That way it'll hold it in place for me. Okay, now we're gonna insert the drive shaft in first. Just like so. And we're gonna brace it with our leg. And we're going to make sure we line up the splines with our shift shaft. And we're going to take one of our bolts that we took over here with us and go ahead and start threading it in place. Okay, now we've got our bolt in place, our lower unit's held in place. Now it's time to install the remainder of the lower unit bolts. Okay, we've got our four bolts in place for the lower unit. Now let's go ahead and torque them down to spec. These bolts need to be torqued down to 29 foot-pounds. Let's don't forget the one that goes underneath the trim tab. And we're going to torque it to 29 foot-pounds as well. Okay, next we're going to take our trim tab and we're going to line it up with the marks that we made right before we took it off. That way it goes back in the same spot.
Just like that.
Next we're going to take our bolt. Thread it onto the trim tab. Also going to torque our trim tab bolt to 29 foot-pounds as well. The last thing we have to do is put our cap back on our trim tab bolt. Okay, another job in the books. Really wasn't that tough, was it? Listen, for parts used in this project and more, check us out at boats.net and we can get you taken care of. If you have any questions or comments, leave them in the section below and I'll do my best to answer. Just want to say thanks for watching and we'll see you next time.